In accordance with Vietnamese tradition and on behalf of the groom's family, we brought gifts to the Nguyen family of fruits, teas, wines, sweets, and a roasted pig to state our intention to ask your family for Julie Vi Han Nguyen to become the bride of our family.
And this is also like the sweet with a square shape to represent the earth. And we also have the sweet rice and with the letter that for happiness.
Thank you.
And here is the tea. Thank you so much, Amy.
Our honor.
And we also have like another something here. So could you just give me like a second so I can arrange so we can take a very nice
Dear Kirk, Amy, Roberta, and all your relatives and friends coming all the way from Chicago and elsewhere. My name is Hung Nguyen, and I'm the bride's father. Next to me is my wife, Thuy, my son Peter, and his wife, Arlene, and Thuy's brother, Tung. Thien is our friend, Thien and Phúc, our friend. And where's Michelle? Oh, Michelle, the great honor. Yes, forgot about that.
Cũng rất là cảm động khi mà có bạn bè với họ hàng đã tới đây tham dự cái ngày lễ gia tiên của hai cháu Vi Hà và Sơn. Bây giờ thì con xin phép được lên để mà dẫn cháu xuống gặp mọi người.
On behalf of the groom's family, I would like to send my best wishes to all the guests who are present here today. Dear Hung and Thuy, now that your family has accepted our gifts in the presence of our relatives and friends, Amy and I are formally asking you to allow Julie Vi Han Nguyen to be our daughter-in-law. At the same time, we also ask your family and ancestors to accept Grant Johnson as your son-in-law.
Dear Kirk, I agree that today is a perfect day for our family to receive your request. First, our family would like to thank the groom's family for being so well prepared. On behalf of the bride's family and our ancestor, we appreciate your precious gift. And officially welcome Grant Johnson as our son-in-law. And as a new member of the Nguyen and Le family. At the same time, we requested the groom's family to welcome Julie Vi Han Nguyen to your family as daughter-in-law as part of the Johnson and Mr. Rack families.
Yes, we would be more than happy to accept Julie as our daughter-in-law.
Then we would like to start the ceremony to introduce the Julian Grant as our daughter and son-in-law to our ancestor. I'm sure that with this blessing, our Julian Grant would live a happy and healthy life, have a successful career, and with the hope that the brides and grooms parents would one day be proud and happy grandparents. Thank you. So next, we would like to offer incense to our ancestor and seek their blessing. First, I would like to speak to our ancestor in Vietnamese and then in English. Afterward, Kurt and I, Kurt and Amy are invited to also offer their thoughts to the ancestor. Now I would like to ask Kurt and Amy to Thuy and Grant and Julie to move into the center of the altar. Hôm nay là ngày lành tháng tốt, được sự đồng ý và thống nhất của gia đình hai bên. Chúng con xin chính thức cử hành hôn lễ cho hai cháu Grant Johnson và Vi Hà Nguyễn. Chúng con xin dâng các lễ vật theo truyền thống đến các chư vị tổ tiên. Mong các vị tổ tiên phù hộ cho hai cháu trăm năm hạnh phúc, đầu bạc đăng long, trăng long, răng long. Chúng con xin thành tâm kính khẩn. Dear spiritual and blood ancestor of our family, we as the parents of Julie and Grant are now offering our respect and appreciation for your support during our lifetime. We are very happy to inform you that Julie will have Grant as her lifetime partner, and we are sincerely asking for your approval and blessing for their 100-year-long and happy marriage.
Dear family, my mother's passed away in March, and Julie went home to her. She has been taking care of my mom since the last 10 years, and this is a gift that my mom would like to give to her. Yes, so I will have a chance to put it in here.
Having been witnessed by our ancestor, relative, and friends, the ancestral blessing ceremony is now complete. Julie and Grant are part of both families. Grant and Julie, would you have anything to share with your family and friends?
So we both just wanted to thank everyone for being here, traveling all this way for some of you to make it out to here. As you know, should be clear from the ceremony that we just performed and that you witnessed, it's not just about us, you know, it's about our ancestors, both present and those who have passed away, and our friends and family. And so it really wouldn't be the same without all of you. And so we just want to say thank you.
Well, I mean, he said it all, so. But yes, thank thank you everyone for coming, and it really means a lot to both of us that you guys are all here able to make it. So
thank you. Welcome.
I'm Julie, uncle, and I'm going to shoot it. Tomorrow will be busy for you guys. Okay, so I take this moment, and on behalf of family, thanks a lot for all people coming here for this Easter ceremony. And nothing to say, I hope you are happy for a long time, healthy and successful. And before I stop, who is your favorite president?
Ulysses.
I don't know my Franklin. Well, that's why I have something with all picture on the
everybody, please drink it. Thank you.
On behalf of the groom's family, I would like to invite you to introduce yourselves and offer your congratulations and gifts to the bride and groom. Thank you.
Bride family, you know, I would like the guests in our family to say congratulations to you and Brian. Thank you.
Basically, if you get angry at each other, just talk it out as soon as you can. That would be the most helpful thing that I think could really provide a long-lasting marriage. But from my experience,
yeah, I think
couple
of things that come to my mind right now.
I'm grateful for all that you guys did for me. You know, you guys always had my best interest at heart. And I think Grant also has my best interest at heart, and, you know, most of the time. You know, well, everything that we went through together as a family, you know, all those moments led up to, you know, me being able to meet someone like Grant, having a great partner. So, and then also, thank you for
all that ceremony went just a moment ago, you know.
It's official.
I spend a lot of time back home with you, as now that I'm someone that's, you know, was engaged and now married and getting to spend a lot of time with your family. I'm intrigued. It's really, like Peter said, it's been really nice to just have an opportunity to have two role models to look to. Aren't afraid to be vulnerable with me, and I feel safe. It's been an invaluable resource, and it's for all the, you know, crappy things that COVID brought, I did get to spend a lot of quality time with all of you, and I don't think I would have been able to in the absence of that.
So glad we had a great time spending with you. We get to know you a lot more, and you hear more about it tomorrow.
I'm excited for the speech.
I think everyone's speech is just a roast of Grant, basically.
Thank you.
everyone. Cheers. 100 years.
Finally, I made it here for the big day. A little less than a year ago, I, along with a few others, were able to witness an intimate wedding ceremony on the cliffside overlooking the Potomac River. I'm hoping I can match even half the energy of the officiant that day. I mean, it's really hard to beat out a ponytail-wearing former surfer bro. But wish me luck. Going into 2021, officiating your wedding was not exactly on my list of things to do. I really thought that I would be up here on the side wearing my best green tie or best green suit, but clearly I didn't make the cut. Instead, I got the text from Julie asking if I would like to be the officiant for the wedding. I immediately froze. Clearly, she doesn't know me. I'm definitely afraid of public speaking, and besides, I'm not even licensed, so I definitely can't do it. But she reassured me in true Julie fashion that, trust me, it'll be okay, and besides, we're already married anyway, so it's not that big of a deal. So while my heart's beating like crazy, I still thank you all for giving me the honor to be up here today. Julie, although we share friends at VCU, our friendship really started to grow after college on the dance floor. It felt like every single weekend we were tasting our favorite artists and bonding over our love for house music. We survived 3 days of blazing desert heat in EDC. We really had youth on our side. But luckily for us, the bond we created didn't stop at the music. We started hanging out more, seeking all the best eats in town, and eventually became coworkers and colleagues who can vent our frustrations about work. Who would have thought that our little hangouts chat would still be going strong all these years later, and I'd be calling you one of my best friends. But for those of you who don't have the pleasure of being Julie's best friend, let me describe it to you. You're basically signing up to have the most loving but annoying thorn in your side. Julie is always checking in, pulse check, been going on any dates lately? Did you ask for that raise? Did you finish your speech? No, Julie, I'm working on it. But it's your passion to see your friends grow and be successful that makes you such a truly great and caring friend and an even better wife for Grant. Luckily for me, a good right swipe was enough to distract you for a while with your 6'7" perfect match. He really did not lie on his dating profile. Grant, when I first heard about you, all Julie told me was, yeah, he's just some tall white guy who likes techno. And while you were quiet at first, and honestly, why wouldn't you be, she really made you meet 12 friends all at once at medieval times. The more you stuck around, though, the more I realized that you were more than just a lot of height and a PhD. You drive, attention to detail, and your willingness to put your all into everything that you do is what makes you a good husband for Julie. Whether it's spending hours drilling Fujin's coolest combos in Mortal Kombat, or talking about the positive mental effects that melodic techno and space lasers have on the brain, when you love something, you're all in, learning everything you can about it until you're an expert. And that's clearly transitioned over into your relationship with Julie. I mean, wearing your Dylan Francis is Calvin Harris t-shirt to one of your first dates, pretty sure that sealed the deal. Or even more so, writing haikus describing the adventures of your love. And finally, the most grand gesture of them all, getting down on one knee the same day you had knee surgery. What if you didn't get back up?
I thought about it.
But you were committed to the surprise. You have made getting to know Julie your number one priority, and everyone here can see the love for her, your love for her shine through every day. Now I have the honor to see your relationship grow from the first swipe all the way up to this altar. I know you will continue to carry your love for each other to the UK, and while I'll miss my dancing buddies, I know you'll both be tearing up the international dance floors, exploring new cultures, and continuing to grow with one another. Remember that you have the support of all your friends and family behind you right now. And when in doubt, know that you always have each other to lean on. So while I have zero personal experience in marriage to offer words of wisdom, I did get some inspiration from the great electronic trio Above and Beyond. Julie and Grant, may you never forget about a thing called love. And may you both continue to be each other's sun and moon. Embracing and building off each other's differences in the good times and the bad. One may be a little house and the other a little techno, but together you all will continue to make the perfect music. Now, you all have chosen to write your own vows. It is with these words that you express your binding promises and eternal love for one another. If you are ready to make these promises, I invite you now to face each other, which you already are, and recite your vows. Julie has decided to go first.
In Vietnamese, there are two ways to say the word happiness. The first is vui, which you typically say more casually and usually describe happiness or fun brought about by small, short-lived moments. The other is han phúc, which is more meaningful. You use it when you want to describe something long-lasting and sacred or sacred. I never wanted to settle for someone because I believe everyone deserves someone who would cherish them and bring them happiness, that happiness. This han phúc is why I never wanted to settle for just anyone and to wait for someone like you. I used to regret some of the choices I made in my past, but I firmly believe that if I had taken a different path in my life, I would not have been able to experience this kind of happiness. Which is why on Bumble, of all places, your pleasant surprise The surprise isn't that you are well above 6 feet, or that you putting Italian on your profile means that you can in fact do more than correctly pronounce Italian dishes, or that you are a PhD economist, which I still struggle to sometimes explain to other people when they ask me what you do for a living, or that you extended our match. The biggest and best surprise is that you have a kind and gentle soul. You care for the people around you. I see that in how you treat me, your friends and family, and you know, also my friends and family. You have an extremely calm temperament, which, while sometimes at odds with my more reactive nature, always makes me feel like I can depend on you for just about anything. And above all else, I know that you will always be there for me, and you will never intentionally hurt me. So with that, I promise to always do my best to make you happy, even if it means going to a techno show that lasts from sunset to sunrise. You're one of the hardest working people I know, and it makes me happy when you get to have those moments of joy. I promise to always be honest with you, even when you ask me how I feel, and to not hold in anything, even if it seems irrational. Even in my most heated moments, I know, and I hope you know, that we will be able to work through anything together. And I promise I will always take care of you, even if it means moving across the pond or wherever life takes us. I'm not too worried about our future. I know things will work out because, at the very least, I have you. I love you, and I'm lucky to have found someone to share my life with.
Julie, as much as it makes me cringe to say it, I now truly know what it feels like to marry my best friend. And it really is the best feeling in the world. I love you so much, no matter the time, place, how we're feeling, or what we're doing. Obviously, this includes fun times, like when we're rewatching a Keanu Reeves movie for the fifth time, or going out to the club until 4 a.m. with our wonderful officiant here. But it also includes the more challenging times, like when one of us did something to hurt the other person, which is quite rare, or when one of us forgot to do something, which is a bit less rare. And to me, that's really what this is all about, is finding that person you want to love unconditionally 24/7. And for those in the room that know you, I don't think it's particularly hard to understand why I would feel that way about you. There's the obvious stuff, like the fact that you're beautiful. Consulted with some members of the audience, we determined you do not actually need a PhD to figure that one out. But then there's the more meaningful stuff, and I just wanted to mention one thing in particular. I really admire how you genuinely listen, try to understand how and why I feel the way I do, and think about how best to support me in each situation without ever encroaching on my own individual autonomy, which as I think my parents would agree is something pretty important to me. And the best part is you don't just do this for me, you do this for everybody in your life, which is why this room is filled with friends and family members who love you. But that being said, I'm the lucky one that gets to spend the rest of my life with you, and I couldn't be more excited. I love you. I love you so much that I promise to forever maintain our deal stating that you never have to watch sports ball of any kind unless I agree to watch an episode of The Bachelor in return. But more seriously, I promise to always respect and support your individuality, your interests and hobbies, even if they end up creating extra dishes for me. Speaking of which, I promise to do the dishes each night, more realistically, maybe every other night, and pick up various things that mysteriously end up on the ground, even after a long day of work or when I'm tired. And I guess what I'm trying to say is that I promise to do the small things to help you out just for the sake of doing them and not expecting anything in return, even when I might not want to. Which brings me to my final vow. I promise to genuinely work at this relationship each and every day, during the good times, bad times, and everything in between. And I can't help but smile when I think of what we've already built together and wherever life takes us, whether it's London, back here, or anywhere else. I know that we'll be able to tackle whatever gets thrown in our way, dancing all the way. I love you.
Now, please take each other's hands. Grant, do you take this woman, promising to love, honor, and respect her through all the days of your life?
I do.
Julie, do you take this man, promising to love, honor, and respect him through all the days of your life?
I do.
Jason, could you please bring forward the rings? This was not fun. Julie and Grant, let these rings represent your internal love and the promises you have made here today. Let them be a symbol of your unbreakable bond in this new beginning of your life together with no end in sight. Grant, you already have the ring. As you place this on Julie's finger, please repeat after me. Julie.
Julie.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As my symbol of my eternal love.
As a symbol of my eternal love.
And commitment to you.
And commitment to you.
And Julie also has the ring. Julie, as you place this on Grant's finger, please repeat after me. Grant.
Grant.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my eternal love.
As a symbol of my eternal love.
And commitment to you.
And commitment to you.
And now, with zero power vested in me, I now pronounce you husband and wife again. You may now kiss your bride.
Technically our wedding, but you know, it wouldn't be the same if you guys weren't all able to make it. And I know a lot of you traveled from very far away to make it during challenging times that aren't quite back to normal yet. And so thank you from the bottom of our heart, because it really wouldn't be the same without all of you here. And now I would hand the mic over to Julie's father.
So I've been waiting for this moment for 29 years. Thanks, Julie. And I must say that this is one of the most difficult things that I ever had to do. Although it is overwhelming to give your daughter away, it is also satisfying to know that she will be in great hands with her tall and handsome husband, Grant. kính thưa quý vị, tôi là Hưng, là bố của cô dâu và xin đại diện cho hai họ để chào mừng toàn thể quan khách và tất cả mọi người trong một buổi tiệc đầy vui vẻ. Xin trình bày với quan họ là tuy hơi trễ nhưng mà chúng tôi đợi 29 năm và tới ngày hôm nay và rất vui và yên chí khi được bàn giao cô bé Vi Hà cho người chồng đẹp trai và cao lớn như là Grant. Ladies and gentlemen, this is an important day for me since I was given an itemized bill and also told that this is not yet the final one. So I really need to resuscitate my bank account and hand over Julie's spending habit to Grant, the economist. But before I forget, I would like to thank the officiant, Garrett. Who did a wonderful job tonight. My wife, Thuy, who spent countless hours for this wedding. And of course, Julie and Grant for organizing this wonderful event. Her brother, Tung Le, where's Tung? Okay. And, you know, my wife's father, Dan Le, who came from California. Where's Dan? There. My son Peter and his wife Arlene.
Yeah.
Yeah. Right. And my sister Kim and her family from San Diego.
Yeah.
Yeah, that over there. My favorite cousin Simon Nghiêm. also from California. A lot of people from out of town here. Of course, and then of course the groom's grandmother, Roberta. And of course, the groom's parents, Kurt and Amy, from Chicago. Groom's sister, Dana, and her fiancé, Leo, over there. Yeah. They're from Raleigh, North Carolina. And numerous local and distant family and friends from both sides who came and became part of this wonderful celebration, either in person or in spirit. Needless to say, thank you, Julie and Grant, for doing the heavy lifting for us. Our apology to you if there's anything that didn't turn out to be right during this event. Chúng tôi cũng xin cảm ơn anh Garrett là làm chủ buổi chủ hôn trong buổi lễ rất là trang trọng. Xin cảm ơn bà xã Thủy đã bỏ rất nhiều thời giờ, năng lượng cho dịp tân hôn này. Cảm ơn con trai Sơn và vợ là Ái Linh, chị Ngân gia đình đến từ San Diego, em họ Thúy đến từ San Orange County và anh Tùng. Và tất cả mọi người đã trong gia đình và bạn bè, trong hai họ từ xa tới hay là ở đây, chung vui chúng tôi trong dịp này. Yesterday, we had a very beautiful and traditional Vietnamese ceremony called the Ancestral Blessing.
also known as the Tea Party, where the groom's family came to our place with trays of gift and even a roasted pig to ask for permission from both our family ancestors, ask for blessing from them for 100 years long and happy marriage. But no pressure, but with plenty of children. As I look at Julie, the bride, with a lovely wedding gown, I can't help but reflect on the girl she was and the woman she has become. She became the daddy's girl, for sure, on the day she was born, and has been a princess to me. All through her life, she has brought joy to us. And while not every day has been perfect, the love I feel for her has been and always will be. So as you remember, Julie has been a very beautiful and cheerful girl, but she always bursts out crying when seeing her uncle-in-law, Zong, who's here in the audience today over there. So we couldn't figure out why, but it turned out that you know, my brother-in-law Zong has a mustache. So I'm so glad that Grant shaved all his facial hair when he started to date Julie. But he does have a hair now, so. So when Julie told us that she met Grant using the dates app. So I asked Julie, you met your boyfriend off at dating apps? You couldn't do what the old-fashioned way by dating literally just some guy who we or your friend think could be a good match for you? She said no, of course. I think she because she prefers to swipe left or right because of thumbs up or down. So during COVID-19, we had an opportunity to host Grant when he returned from Europe before the entry door to US is shut. So it was our precious moment to get to know Grant from the time he was in the 2 weeks quarantine where he had to sit more than 6 feet away from us for dinner. It was something that's kind of hard to describe. Until he was able to find his own place, of course. What we found was that Grant was really a hardworking and very responsible person. Of course, he does, you know, dishwashing very well. Person with a great sense of humor. She also had an acquired taste of wine and especially international food. It was so good that when Grant came over secretly to ask for our permission to marry Julie, I basically said yes without saying why. So as far as any fatherly wisdom, we can offer a quote from the book, How to Love by Zen Master Thich Nhat Hanh, who's definitely our favorite. It goes like this. If our parents didn't love and understand each other, how are we to know that what love looks like? There aren't courses or classes in love. If the grown-ups know how to take care of each other, then the children who grow up in this environment will naturally know how to love, understand, and bring happiness to each other. The most precious inheritance that parents can give to their children is their own happiness. Our parents may be able to leave us money, houses, or land, but they may not be happy people. If we have happy parents, we have received the richest inheritance of all. So that's kind of, you know, what I think is important in the kind of going along with the vows that we've seen today. So as we know that Julie and Grana are going to embark on a new adventure and move to London with plenty of exciting opportunities to travel and discover new cultures, we will certainly miss you as parents. And let's hope that we can stay happy and pass that on to you. Julian Grant, your friends and family surround you right now as you're beginning something new and precious. Remember your promise. Keep them with all your heart, and you will have that sense of joy and wonder that exceed all you have known. But last but not least, we wish you the best of your upcoming European tour. But we surely hope to welcome you back with wide open arms as your tour ends. So with all my heart to this toast, I offer Julian Grant my congratulations and warmest wishes as you begin the upcoming adventure in life. So let's give them a toast.
I've known Grant for about 8 years. We were both in the PhD program in economics at UC San Diego. Back then, we were both 22 years old, fresh out of college, Grant from Northwestern, me from Pitt. And I look back at that time, and I honestly had no idea what I was getting myself into. There were a lot of things I didn't expect. One being how much graduate school would suck. But the thing I least expected, and the thing that I'm ultimately most thankful for in that time, is that I would meet the best friend I've ever had in my life. Certainly, I've had friends that I've known longer, people I grew up with, people from high school and from college and whatnot. And I made many incredible lifelong friends in graduate school as well, many of whom are here. But, and guys, don't take this the wrong way, none of them is like Grant Johnson. Outside of my mom and dad, there is no one person on this earth who has had more of an impact on me than this guy. Grant, you saw things in me that I did not see in myself. You helped me find a confidence in myself and a love for myself that I thought might always elude me. I would not be the person that I am if I hadn't met you. Straight fact. And it's one of the great honors in my life that I get to be up here in front of all of these people and tell you the following. I love you. And I will love you forever. This is where you play the Celine Dion music. Yeah. And it will be another great honor in my life. And I don't know when it will be, but it will be someday. One day, I will be in that seat. And you will be up here giving this speech for me. Now, I haven't known Julie that long. In fact, it's been just about a year. And I heard a lot at first from Grant, then from some friends, mutual friends. I knew they had a lot of shared interests and commonalities, one being one of the other great loves of Grant's life, John Wick. Exactly. And when I did finally meet Julie, it was under pretty unfortunate circumstances. About this time last year, my mother passed away. And on that day, I called Grant, because if there was anyone that I was going to call, it was going to be this guy. And he and Julie dropped everything, and they came to visit me and my dad in Pittsburgh. And while they were visiting us, they came over, and what did we do? We had a bunch of drinks, and we watched John Wick. Yeah! It's in moments like that, when you see the measure of people and who your true friends really are. And in a moment where I felt like I had lost so much, I was still able to see that I had absolutely everything that I needed. Fortunately, Julie and I have had time to see each other since then and get to know each other. And I just want to say this. You only want the best for your friends. And you want the very best for your best friends. Grant, I think you found that. I'm so happy that you guys have each other and that you've allowed me to be part of the most important day in your lives, because it's also one of the most important in mine. So with that, I want to raise a toast to Grant and Julie. Yay.
I memorized it. I don't need the paper for this one. Remembrance of the wolf shirt. I joined the wolf pack. 'Twas paired with a kimono. Aliens deaf exist. Now, that is not 575. It never has been. I have been holding in since September 11th when you proposed. Moment of silence. That happened for this moment when I can go one deeper. William Shakespeare wrote an iambic pentameter because it matches the rhythm of your heart. Unstressed, stressed. I wrote you a sonnet. It is 14 lines. It is the correct rhyme scheme. And each line is 10 syllables. It is called Reflections on My Best Friend. Plur will guide us. But soft, what love at yonder table sit. Grant is the groom and Julie is the bride. Right when they matched on Bumble, they had lit a spark to spend a lifetime side by side. Julie is a sunflower in the moon, her golden petals dancing in the night. Just as a spell, Grant fell and cast a rune. They go as a river in love and light. And as you both set off beyond the shore, fair winds and seas that follows guide your sails. You've been through ups and downs in love before. Cherish each other through all life entails. Julie, you are the best person I know, and I love you both much more than words can show. Let's go one more deeper. Dylan Francis said it better than I ever could. Money sucks, friends rule. Mahalo. Cheers, guys.
Monster's gone, he's on the run, and your daddy's here. Beautiful, 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 beautiful boy. Beautiful, 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 beautiful boy. Before you go to sleep, say a little prayer every day, in every way. It's getting better and better. Beautiful, 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 beautiful boy. Beautiful, 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 beautiful boy. Sailing away, I can hardly wait to see you come of age. But I guess we'll both just have to be patient, 'cause it's a long way to go. A hard road to hoe. Yes, it's a long way to go, but in the meantime, before you cross the street, take my hand. Life is what happens to you while you're busy making other plans. Gone. There's that on.
There's nothing more that I would have that I could need. Cause having this means that I got it all. When I was taking turns and you were wrong for me, you chose to understand and let it go. And oh, you've turned this black heart, made it into gold. So I wanna let you know that my love and my touch up above is made with the one for my, my love and my touch up above is made with the one for my love, oh love. Control is such an open-ended word for me. Something that I used to think I owned. I'm standing here with none, I'm feeling so complete. You help me understand and let it go. And oh, you've turned this black heart, made it into gold.